Someone tell me why nobody is talking about this. This is actually disgusting. Bone plating is actually incredibly strong right now. Bone plating not only blocks 20 to 50 damage from 3 autos or abilities, but you have second wind that heals 4% of your missing health plus 6 over 10 seconds. That's insane! Plus, you have the option to take Doran's Shield, restoring 6 HP every 5 seconds, and an additional 20 health over 10 seconds after taking damage from a champion. I haven't seen anybody talk about this, and this rune, it's not overpowered by any means, but it's really disgusting. Who can use this? Pretty much any laner can take this. Mid laners who get poked, example Echo into Azir, Echo loses against Azir due to Azir poking, so you have to stay safe. You can see here that with Bone Plating and Second Wind and Doran's Shield, I take absolutely no damage. I can go in, take a bad trade, and still come out on top, even though that I fucked up so much. And Azir was able to poke me down. I was actually able to survive this laning phase because of plating and second wind and Doran's Shield. I also tried fiddling around without taking Doran's Shield, and the sustain is actually disgusting still. It's really strong. Top laners will be able to trade effectively. If you're a top laner and you take this rune, you don't even have to take second wind. You can take conditioning. In my Pantheon game, I took bone plating and conditioning, and I'm still able to outtrade my opponents very effectively. It's actually disgusting. I don't know what to say about this room. This isn't by any means OP, but it is disgusting when you do take it. If you're a jungler, I couldn't think of any situation where you guys would absolutely need to take this rune, but I can think of a situation where if you know you're gonna get counter jungled this game, you can take bone plating. Bone plating will assure you that if you get counter jungled, you might be able to actually survive that counter jungle. I'm telling you right now, I can't think of any situation where junglers can take this rune and it'll be worth it compared to other runes. So unless a jungler main out there that's higher elo can think of something, I wouldn't recommend it. ADCs. I think as ADC, you do have to take Bone Plating, Second Wind, and Doran's Shield to make this worth your time, but only take this rune if the ADC you're picking is currently bad in lane. You don't want to pick this rune if your ADC is good in the meta right now, because they're good in the meta for a reason. But other than that, going back to ADCs with Bone Plating, it helps with lane survivability. It helps you get through lane. If you know your AD carry is someone like Bane or Kog'Maw that isn't very good in the meta, but just needs to survive lane, taking this rune might help you win the game. Supports. Tanky all-in supports are the only situation where I could think that this rune would make sense for you to take,
such as Leona and Nautilus. Taking bone plating will make them more tanky whenever you decide to fight.
So how do you counter bone plating? You can either take it yourself, and if you originally win that matchup, you'll automatically win based off of that, or poke with an auto or ability and then just wait out the 5 seconds, because it has a really long cooldown of 45 seconds. It's easy to counter bone plating, but if you get poked with an ability and you have bone plating, you might as well just go all in. It's already procced and it's going to go on a 45 second cooldown no matter what, so you might as well use that opportunity to trade if you can. So that's it, guys. Go try this out in your normal games. If you're gonna take into ranked games, just know its strengths and weaknesses. You don't want to feed in a ranked game. And with that said, peace!